hear it in the question.
Hey!
Hey, everybody!
Hi! Hello! Welcome! It's Wednesday night. Everyone feels great. It's time for Misadventures.
Yeah!
Wizardry!
Wizardry!
Wizarding Wednesdays!
Woo! That's what it is.
Hashtag.
The best.
I'm Teline Guerra. I'm going to be your GM for this adventure. Who we have at the table today, let's introduce ourselves.
Hi, I am Meghan Caves, and I play a wizard, because why wouldn't you play a wizard in Harry Potter? Yep, that's me.
I was hoping that would go a little longer.
Sorry, nope, throwing it to you.
I'm Blythe, I play Amelia, and hi. I'm super tired today, I hope you guys are doing all right.
Oh no. It's gonna make it so hard to screw with you.
Ready?
Oh no, it's gonna be so easy.
So good. That's all that matters to
me.
Oh
my god. So easy. Hi, I'm Teri Gamble. I am here for Wizarding Wednesday as well. Oh my gosh, I'm a wizard as well.
What?
You're a wizard?
What a coincidence. I know, it's crazy. I play Tarabella Zonks. I am a very old wizard, or pretty young at heart though, eh? All right, sweet.
I'm Mac Beauvais, your friendly neighborhood werewolf, and I am playing Jaina Quickby, who is also a werewolf because that's just what I do with my life.
Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome, you guys. This is chapter 2 of Misadventures and the Broken Wand. And what happened in chapter 1... Did you all check your wands?
Mine is a little
broken?
Bit.
Yes, I did.
What happened in chapter 1... was that Morgana, Megan's character, came down to her kitchen at McStuffin's Muffins to discover somebody had been murdered there. They met a truly awesome auro named Jack.
I don't know about awesome.
The
really
best.
Handsome.
He's British handsome. British
he
handsome.
Isn't anymore.
Poor guy.
No.
Oh yeah, he's like troll handsome right now.
Ah, fixed it him.
Jack Duke came to solve the mystery of who this guy was who got murdered, and he and his trainee Eloise Poppenjay are investigating the murder, but all signs apparently are pointing towards Morgana as being the killer.
It's not looking good, those blackouts and things. I'm really concerned.
Yeah, well.
Yeah, you should have that looked at.
Well, yeah.
So through a series of strange coincidences, she ran into some old friends.
That's us.
That's these guys who were all here at Diagon Alley to celebrate Chicken Bear Day.
The best holiday.
Everyone loves Chicken Bear Day. And during Chicken Bear Day, there are two major events that happen. People pull pranks on each other. That's the nice part of Chicken Bear Day. And the less nice illegal part is that wizards bring their monstrous creations to fight it out in illegal underground monster fights.
Like this one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like this one.
Like that one.
What is that one?
It's some kind of monster.
Okay.
We'll see later what it is.
Oh no.
With cool clothes on, I guess. I don't know.
I'm terrified kind of. Already.
During last week's adventure, a few things happened of note. One, Jaina Quickby turned into a werewolf in the middle of Diagon Alley in a crowded street in the middle of the day.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That was bad.
Another thing that happened was that Jaina explored Morgana's mind, and when she came out of Morgana's mind, Morgana attacked.
Because she's attack? Crazy pants.
Yeah.
Hi.
Because she's crazy pants.
Well.
Or perhaps crazy trousers.
There you go.
Breeches, maybe. Breeches.
I think breeches would be worse than pants.
Would it?
Yeah.
Well, pants is underwear, if we're going strictly
it
British.
Well, so is breeches.
Amelia.
So sounds fancier, though.
Amelia had a vision of a door opening in cauldrons, cauldrons, cauldrons. Am I missing anything important?
There was a lot that happened,
we followed Trini to the store, and then we got attacked, and there was a bunch of crazy pranks, and
we do know that Morgana had gone to
the Leaky Cauldron.
The Leaky Cauldron.
Mm-hmm.
And then everything went dark.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She's got a lot of blank spaces.
It's tough for Morgana to defend herself against these accusations because she cannot remember what happened.
It's true.
Uh-oh.
No bueno.
You guys can join in and participate in our craziness through chat donations. You can trigger Morgana's bloodlust. You can trigger Jaina's bad mood rising, which turns her into a werewolf. For Terabella Zonx, you can trigger I happen to have, which means that she happens to have whatever piece of muggle technology you think she ought to have.
I had a whistle last time, a dog whistle that came in very handy.
It was nice.
When we had an animagus and a werewolf to deal with.
Yep.
Got those dogs right in line. I'm sorry.
And Amelia. Not dogs. For I'm Amelia, you
getting
can
hate. She's just giving the dirtiest look for calling them dogs.
That's racist.
I know. I'm so sorry, you guys. But in light of these last week's events, I am so sorry.
So rude.
I should not have been gaslighting anyone. I'm not dog whistling for anyone. Okay, so let's change these things.
Be the change you want to see in the world.
Oh my
Terrible
god.
Zonks.
Okay.
The other thing you can do is you can trigger, for Amelia, you can trigger one of two things. You can either trigger crystal balls, which will give her an accurate premonition of something to come, or you can trigger deja whoops, which will give her an inaccurate premonition of something to come. Mm. I won't tell her which one you triggered. I'll just tell her who you are, who did it to her. Mm. You can also pay to make these guys eat Birdie Bot's terrible flavored beans.
Hey, you don't want to show them all of the good ones out of the packages.
I was about to confess to that. I had these in my house. I got hungry for some sugar. So I went through and pulled out all the good tasting ones.
All right, for the right amount, I'm still willing to shotgun like the rest of a box.
It's all the nasty ones.
I am not even kidding. Like, it has to be worth it. I'm sure someone will make a judgment call on that.
Grass and
That is how much I care about raising funds for this stream.
All right, well.
I will debase myself for your amusement more than usual.
I just realized I have three re-rolls.
Oh, you have three re-rolls from last time that you didn't get back?
I don't have any, so just gonna put that out there now.
I have a
I wouldn't mind. We have one for the table, but I wouldn't mind some individual ones. Just plug.
Hey. I have a resub one that I'm gonna give you. One from one of my resubs. Right. So she has a re-roll now.
Thanks.
What? Dumb! What's happening here?
I can do that.
Go shake your head at me.
Yes.
I'm a sub to the channel.
Yes.
Am I a sub? I want to give myself a reroll.
Let them know that they can do that too.
Yeah. If you sub, you can get rerolls for one of us. You can help us out.
Or me.
No, for us.
For us.
I'm the only one that appreciates your chaos.
Thank you. Someone has to.
But I still prefer that they come to me.
I appreciate the chaos. But I also appreciate being able to fight back in the chaos.
Because whatever she's got right now, I'm terrified. She's been talking about it all day on the Twitter, and I'm
a
little nervous.
She made up a Christmas carol for it.
Yeah.
I was inspired.
Well, How does it go?
I don't remember. Carol? It was the night before Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no.
It was the night before Chicken Bear Day.
Oh,
yeah, that's
no.
What it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was not... Cheery or holiday.
Go on Twitter, follow her, look at her tweets, and you can see the diabolical mastermind that is our DM.
Yes.
It's what, Teline makes things or Teline makes stuff?
Teline makes this. Teline made this.
You don't even remember. We've completely just ruined you.
It's all right. I have. I'm fixated on the things.
I know your real name. I was trying to remember your Twitter handle, though.
So remember all the ways that you can influence the game. The last thing that you guys can do is you can cast Revelio. There are going to be people that these guys interact with who may or may not be lying to them. A Revelio token gives them the opportunity to take any statement said by an NPC or another player and find out instantly whether or not it is true or false.
I have one. I can't wait.
There it is.
I'm ready.
Now, is there anything else I wanted to say?
I don't know. Was there anything else you wanted to say?
An evil laugh. That was probably it.
Now, we join them again as they are headed to cauldrons, looking for the other side of the magic door.
Yep.
to see if this magic door is a deja whoops or a crystal balls. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure.
Give you a little.
Oh, yes.
This one.
Do you have a
thing? Before we get
all I know is that first vision was donated by Steven, so if it's wrong,
it doesn't matter. You didn't even remember there were cauldrons in it in the first place.
Ooh. Yeah, but I can still give Steven crap.
Okay, everybody.
Yep.
Wizardry.
Wizardry! Yes, all of that.
We're adorable.
I'm glad someone thinks so.
Here you are at Cauldrons is an upscale cauldron shop where you get your high-end cauldrons, your name brand cauldrons. As you walk in, you can see that they have many display cauldrons laying around, and the middle of the room is the deluxe extra large cauldron model. There's a little sales table back here, and behind it is the person who owns and runs Cauldrons.
Now, which wall is corresponding to the adjacent shop?
Cindra Lopez is her name. She is the owner of Cauldrons.
What was her name again? Cindra?
Mm-hmm. Have you walked inside Cauldrons?
We have.
Cindra draws her wand.
Oh, hello. Is this standard?
She points it at Morgana. You come in here to make trouble again? You come in here to make trouble? I told you not to come in here anymore.
You did? No, I'm not here to make any trouble. I don't remember you saying that. When did you say that? When was I here?
I said that when you came in here the other day, ranting about there being holes in the walls. And that you, no, that's not what you ranted about. That's what you're about to rant about. What you ranted about then, which you was like, someone came in here. So where is they? Where is he? Where is he hiding? And I was like, there's no one in here. And you didn't believe me. You looked in all of my cauldrons.
I did.
Crazy.
I apologize for that. Who was it that was in here? No one. No one was in here.
No one was in here. No, you was here. Crazy.
Well,
Morgana, you are so silly. You started Chicken Bear Day early, obviously.
Oh, yes.
Oh, did you get your calendar wrong?
I did. I often do that.
That's a terrible trick.
I apologize. Yes, well, it was funny though, right?
Oh. Oh. Well, I guess an early Chicken Bear prank is a very Chicken Bear thing to do.
Yes, she's ahead of the curve.
It's an ultimate Chicken Bear thing.
Mm-hmm. Well, next time tell me it was a Chicken Bear prank a lot sooner. I told some horrors in here, if you came in here, that you came in red and being crazy.
Oh, well, that's a prank on them too, so I'll tell them later, they're friends of mine.
Now, which wall was she headed to anyway? I mean, did she check everything, or did she seem particularly fixated on one wall? We've been tracing steps, you know.
Oh, I misspoke when I said wall. She didn't know about a wall then.
Oh.
She just came in saying, like, where is he? And looked in all the cauldrons.
Oh, in the cauldrons. Ooh,
have you, by chance, had anyone playing a prank on you? Maybe making doors appear for no reason in a wall, or
stacks of cauldrons knocking over?
Yeah.
Don't be ridiculous. No one's done that. There's no holes in any walls. The walls are solid walls. It's just good walls. Like a Chicken Bear prank was knock over my cauldrons. Not funny. Mm. No one did anything like that. Somebody did put a fart sound in one of the cauldrons, so every time you touched it, it made a fart sound.
Oh.
And it was a wicked difficult fart sound spell to get rid of, but that's all the worst that's happened to me.
Sounds very Chicken Bear.
It was not a big fan of Chicken Bear Day.
Yeah.
To be honest.
Oh, really?
To be honest.
Oh, but it's so
could
fun.
Could you close down your shop for the week if you wanted to?
I could, but
I feel like people don't really buy cauldrons.
The crowds are big and I've got high-end cauldrons here.
You do?
This cauldron right here, it's 10,000 quid.
Wow.
I need lots of people to come by and see it so I can finally sell this thing.
I'm actually a regular here. I need to come here for work a lot. So I like your cauldrons. You make good stuff.
Oh, thank you. I pride myself on my excellent inventory.
It's fantastic.
That's so nice of you to say. Well, I like you. Don't know what you're hanging around with this one for, but
oh, she's
come on in, let me show you the latest model.
Of course.
You see what they've done with cauldron technology is it's leapt forward this last year. In terms of color, no longer are we stuck with our black cauldrons. Now we've got off black cauldrons and dark, dark gray cauldrons.
Really? That's exciting. I like them.
Fascinating.
In fact, where's my cauldron that I painted? Put it on the table. Bring me my cauldron!
Of course!
I am so nothing pleased. If not predictable.
So pleased. I love it.
If you look at this here cauldron, it also has some decorative skulls around it. Ooh. And inside it's like some wood or something. I don't know what it is. But it got painted nice. So, here. Let me light it up, get a spell going, show you how it works.
Right, totally.
Well, why didn't you do that? I'd love to have just a bit of a look around. I actually have not been in your shop before, and I would love to just you know, look at the offerings that you have.
Well, absolutely. The less expensive cauldrons are at the front of the store, the nicer stuff's in the back.
Oh,
you can
lovely.
See that we've got little special showrooms for high-end, high-def cauldrons.
I mean, only the finest, obviously.
Obviously. Yes, no, help yourselves. Look around.
Of course.
If you have any questions, I'm here. Let me continue to show you the features of this cauldron.
Of course.
Shall we?
Cinder, yes. Yes.
Winking at you the whole time.
Okay.
All your spells will come out 1,000 times more potent with this cauldron.
It's a fantastic cauldron. I bet everyone at the Ministry would be so jealous if I got this.
Oh my goodness, this is definitely an aspirational cauldron.
I love it. Love it, it's fantastic. So if you were to... And now, when you're brewing potions, what's the heat level that it can handle?
Well, this model is one of our high heat models. It can handle up to dragonfire level temperatures.
Really?
Fire.
And it doesn't start to crack or break or burn?
No, I'm going
to
say, don't leave it, like, it's one of those things, right? It's
can
like...
Just put a spell on her to, like, make her, like, stop talking for a moment, and then we can look around.
Oh, I do think so.
Why don't we just do that real quickly?
Hold on.
Well, there is glue's opponent's tongue to roof of mouth.
Yes, there is. There is
also doing this, so you guys...
Right, so we can go look around. Mm-hmm. So we're looking around while she's just gibber-jabbering.
Well, actually, better than that, why don't I cast Muffliato, which is one of my free spells.
Fantastic.
Which means that no one can hear
when we're talking about.
So, Muffliato. So, and now we can at least talk.
Right.
I mean, where do we start? We don't have any clues or anything aside from it's the cauldron shop.
Well, it was upstairs, right?
So let's head upstairs.
So we should go upstairs. And it would be this wall, I think.
Over here?
Yes.
All right.
That's the one that's next to the outpost.
Okay. We head upstairs. We look.
I actually feel bad for Amelia.
I do and I don't. She seems keenly fascinated by it.
That is true. She is a bit odd.
That or she's taking one for the team.
It could possibly be both.
I feel like she's taken one for the team before.
All right, now... We're
what?
Here.
I'm sorry.
Whoa.
What?
No, we have Muffliato on. You can't hear her.
Sorry. So sorry. Sorry, Leah. All right. So what do we find?
I'm going to be the first to die.
I mean, honestly, what are we looking for? We're here on a hunch that might not even be a correct hunch.
But then there may be something here. So let's look for this wall.
I mean, Morgana, obviously you were here before, but you don't realize it.
Obviously, yes. Yes, I say we try and look at this wall at the very least and see if, I mean, so...
I mean, we can try a little more, but I mean, that's pretty basic.
It is. I don't know that it would work on something like this, but I mean, we could try it anyway. The only thing that would probably work is, where did it go? I don't think we can use it, though. Specialist Relievium, is that what it's called?
Because honestly, the only other thing I could do is go down to the shopkeeper, try and dive into her mind and get something out of it. But, I mean, that's a bit obtrusive and a bit over the
she
top if I need to.
She may not even know that there's anything up here.
Yeah.
That's true as well.
She might have just been startled by a XOR running around her shop, yelling that they're looking for someone.
I wonder if she could have been obliviated, though, as well. I mean, if something did happen, I mean, obviously she remembers me coming in, but she doesn't remember anyone else. Maybe no one else was here.
There's too many options. That's the problem.
Well, I think the specialist Revelio might be the best. Let's try.
All right.
They're having way too much fun right now.
On this wall, specialist Revelio.
Okay, so it's really hard to mime that I'm talking and listen to you at the same time.
What did you decide to do?
But you did a lovely job of it. Lovely.
Thank you.
We wanted to see if we can use specialist Revelio on the wall, which reveals hidden secrets or magic properties. Now, is that what this is? Can we not use it?
No.
That's different.
Okay, it's different. That's okay. Find out if somebody's lying.
That's what I do. On the wall. The wall that
Which
is...
Which particular wall?
So we're upstairs, the wall that is would be connected to the outpost. Which I assume is this one.
Okay. Is it any of your natural spells?
That's what was confusing. These were backwards last time. I keep looking at the shelf fronts and I'm very confused.
I can't remember.
Specialize in that, but I did do it successfully once before, so I do have a plus to it.
You do have a plus.
You can cast it if you want.
Let's see, it's a level 2, and I do have a plus 1. Shall I?
Do it.
I hate this arrangement. This is the higher sides are in.
That was terrible. Someone else should try it.
I can try.
What? No, no!
Sell that case!
Someone else, because...
Specialist Revelio.
Obviously, I'm off my game.
That's an 8.
We are awful.
Ask Selden if he wants me to use new dice that are pretty or new dice that are ugly.
Wow.
He said blessed dice.
Blessed dice?
Oh.
Do your dice sing. Which ones? Which ones sing?
All right. You can decide which one are the blessed dice.
I get to decide?
Yeah.
Well.
There's also this really pretty one.
There is.
Well, we both sucked at that, so would you like to have a crack at it?
I'll give a go.
I think you should use these, because these look like something someone evil would use.
The red ones?
Yes.
Am I gonna go first?
Well, we already rolled unsuccessfully. So try and get the wall to reveal a secret.
Okay.
What? We are terrible.
I also rolled an 8.
Wow.
We have 3 rolls, if we feel like it's important.
I mean, honestly, I feel like this is a fool's errand. We might be better served. Going off
getting the
to
hell
the
out
pub.
Of this place.
Maybe.
And going to the Leaky Cauldron, since that is available this week.
Well, I suppose we could always...
Leaky Cauldron, new and available this week.
We could always come back here if we need to, I suppose.
We can, and we've smoothed things over a bit with the shopkeeper, so it might not be so difficult.
Leah.
Didn't even know we needed to do that, but at least
you're welcome for the quick thinking about Chicken Bear Day.
You think that over, you think over things
yes.
I told
Thank
you, and you come back anytime.
Of course. Right.
Payment plans.
Oh, yes.
Lovely shop. Thank you so much. We may be coming back.
Pleasure. I mean, definitely come back. Definitely come back.
Of course.
I'm gonna have some kind of Chicken Bear Day sale. I don't know how that'll go over there. People think it's a prank. I don't know. I don't understand this holiday at all.
Yep.
Okay, bye. Awkward.
I'm all alone with my cauldrons. The dance around them and I love them.
Crazy cauldron lady.
So you guys are out in the square now?
So let's head to the Leaky Cauldron.
Yes.
Let's head to the other cauldron, apparently. So,
yeah. Okay, so the Leaky Cauldron's over there. So you're crossing the square. Move my crowd back into place.
Crowd.
Who did I say was going to be?
Listen properly, crowd. Stop being such a mob.
Order, please. Order.
We got some really, like.
You see.
Do we need to be over there?
Ooh, I like him. He might be a better Alaris than my Alaris.
That's
so when you go outside and you start crossing across the street, you see it's Chicken Bear Day is in full swing still. There's lots of pranks being cast, a lot of people laughing, lots of people here. It's a big holiday. And you do see Jack and Eloise are outside of McStuffin's Muffins, like looking in the window, but it's all locked up. So you can choose to go talk to them. Or avoid them.
Oh, Jack is over there.
I mean, maybe he did get bad information from the cauldron's keeper. Maybe we should try and clear that up loudly about your Chicken Bear Day pranks. Wink, wink.
I don't know if that will work on him, but we could certainly try.
We can go and see how ugly he is in person.
That's true. That would be quite fun.
No, he's gotten rid of the
prep.
No!
He also doesn't seem very bright, so he might buy it. true, but you seem to know his... the Jack, other aura.
He's a great guy.
Is just because he's Britishly handsome doesn't make him a great guy.
I know his partner. I went to Hogwarts. We were at Hogwarts together.
Close enough to get some information?
I
It's a simple question, Amelia.
Yes,
I haven't
no.
seen her in a few years, so I don't have a
Are you willing to give it a try?
Sure.
Because we can handle him, and you can maybe have a bit of a chat with her?
Sure. I can probably get in touch with Jack at any point as well if we think it'd be better to go here first.
They've obviously been up and down talking to everyone.
I know, so it might be better to have more information before we talk to them, right?
If we can get more information.
Right. It's but not, we have to try.
It's not better. That's a good point. Also, I really don't want to go
I
back
feel
and
like
talk
you're
to the
avoiding...
Cleveland lady right now.
I don't blame you on that one. She
I don't blame you on that either. All right, so... Maybe what I'll... other information are we going to get from him right now? It's really
I'm not concerned about getting information from
him. You want
him.
To clear her name is what you're worried about.
I'm thinking that he's with another person who has a connection to someone in our party who might be able to wheedle out a little information about who they've talked to so we can backtrack a trail and actually have somewhere to start from rather than she went to the Leaky Cauldron, had a cherry whiskey, and then darkness.
Then blank. You're right. I say we go talk to Jack.
Mm-hmm. You can hang back if you'd like.
No, I think that would be quite worse. I feel like we should find out what's happening here first, but if you all think we should go talk to Jack, we can.
Oh my god, our DM is going to die if we don't make a decision soon.
Oh, let's not make a decision then! Let's keep arguing!
Oh my god, let's at least find out who they talk to if we can, and then that way if we come up dry at a pub, which is ironic, then we have somewhere else to go afterwards.
All right.
Rather than a running all around while pranks are happening all up and down Diagon.
If that's what you want to do.
Well, yes, because I've said so.
Well, we can right. also talk, like, I mean, talking to the bartender wouldn't hurt at the Leaky Cauldron.
And we hope that he has some information. I mean, if you all disagree, then you all disagree, but at least let's say it and move forward with a plan. But
no,
we might come up
half of us think one thing, the other half thinks the other. So it's just about choosing which one we want to go with.
Tiebreaker!
Oh, look, it's a big map. That's what you use for tiebreakers.
It's apparently, the Leaky Cauldron.
Apparently, this Ta-da! Is what's happening now.
Leaky Cauldron.
Do we need to move all these dudes out of the way?
The thing is, you look over at Jack. He's definitely looking in the... Yeah, move them in, too, because the Leaky Cauldron is hopping. They all need to be in the Leaky Cauldron, getting them drinks. That's not where the bar is.
Yeah,
look, there's clearly a bar.
This guy's dancing on his table. So is this guy.
Okay. You look over at Jack. The last time you talked to him, he told Morgana that he was not going to tell you anything else about the course of his investigation because she was the primary suspect.
I wasn't thinking that he'd be the one we pumped for information.
Mm. We probably
trying to get it from Eloise.
We got to get it from her separately, though. I doubt that she'll say much when he's there.
That's why someone would have to pull her away for a conversation. Man. But as that didn't happen, we are now in a
bar. Where's the door?
This is the front door. There's two front doors.
I'm thrilled. This is where I live half of the time. I'm very happy to be here.
Let me explain the Leaky Cauldron to you. You come in the front doors and you enter the bar area. This is the bar. These are the bar stools. There's the taps. And I guess it would be a pub because we're in England. Sorry. And there's the bottles. It's very well drawn. And there's tables everywhere for people to sit at. And if you go to the back of the Leaky Cauldron, you can go back this way, where there are four private dining areas for secret parties. And they have chimneys in them for transportation. And tables. And these are windows outside. And these have no windows. But if you go up this way, you go up the stairs, and this is where they rent out rooms, which...
Jaina stays at.
Jaina stays at sometimes. See, I drew beds.
Whoa!
They're all brilliant.
What?
We're getting really fancy here.
Don't even question the beds.
I have questions.
But you're going to come in the front into the bar area, And the second Morgana walks in.
Yeah, I was going to say maybe everyone else can go in first. In front of me.
As a buffer.
Just in case.
The second Morgana walks in, like, just, like, if, like, you guys walk in and it's, like, a party. It's everyone's talking, raucous, drinking, laughing, good times, darts are being thrown magically with wands because, you know, they're wizards. But the second Morgana walks in, like, everyone stops talking and turns to look at her. Yeah. It is record scratch city in here.
Hi. Happy Chicken Bear Day, one and all. Is there a problem?
No one answers. It's like,
well, shall we get a drink, ladies?
That sounds great.
As you guys make your way to your to the bar, like people are, they see that you were with Morgana, but they're not so much worried about you. But when Morgana comes close, everyone backs away. Mm. Like, you get to, it's parting the seas. This is a crowded bar, and they just like, nope, you want to go in? Go ahead.
All right, I would know the bartender's name by this
You
point.
Would. Hang on a second. I have all of my...
As we get up here, as they walk away too, can I just turn to one of these people and ask them, why? Why are you backing away?
Oh, no.
They're not going to answer you.
God damn it.
They are scared to death of you, though. You're not in the bookstore.
Next time we're getting you a cloak with a hood, perhaps.
Well, this has never happened before quite like this. It's usually the other way around, but...
You woke up to the bartender, Tom. Tom is the proprietor and landlord of the Leaky Cauldron. Also true in the books, this is canon.
Yes. Tom! How about a
Jaina?
Drink?
Hey! Oh, good to see you! Are you enjoying Chicken Bad Day? What the hell are you doing with her?
Oh, have you met Morgana?
Of course I've met Morgana. I know her drink order, but... Dear God, after what you did last night, I can't believe you've got the balls to show your face in
again
here.
Again with early Chicken Bad Day. What did you do? What did she do? She's such a prankster, and she got it all wrong on her calendar.
This was a prank. I ain't never seen one like it before.
All right, Tom.
What'd you see, Tom?
You know me. What happened? Just tell me what I did.
With your prank?
Yes.
Well, you were sitting there with your drink at a table, and all of us, and this fella came by your table, and he sort of looked at you, and you just lost it. You totally just came out of nowhere. You attacked him. Four people had to pull you off. I had to escort you out of the bar myself.
Really?
And I was like, I'm very sorry, Morgana, and you attacked me.
I did. I apologize for that.
Well, sorry, what was the chap's name?
The chap's name?
Yeah.
Oh, he's not a guy I know.
Oh, really?
He was a stranger to me.
What did he look like?
Skinny-ish fella, dark hair, kind of stringy, bags under his eyes, maybe in his late 40s, early 50s.
Did he talk to anyone else?
Well, yeah, he talked to quite a few people, but
do you know
after Morgana attacked him, he left.
Did he talk to you?
Well, he ordered a drink from me. Oh, he's staying here too, so I talked to him earlier in the day to get him set up in a room.
So you didn't get a name?
I took cash.
You didn't write down in a ledger?
You know what, I probably did. That would be the smart thing to do.
Oh, was that what I heard moving in? I knew somebody else had moved into one of the rooms adjacent. Which is it an adjoining wall room, or was he across the way? I couldn't tell.
No, it wasn't. He was down the hall from you.
Down the hall?
You're mistaken, because it's Chicken Bear Day, and we're at full capacity.
Yes, I mean, it's busy.
I can go look in my ledger. I can go, I do things that are... Yeah, here it is.
I love to know, just because we'd love to clear the air.
His name was Repatrick Mysterium.
Repatrick
Mysterium.
Repatrick.
Do you know where he's from?
Fake, but okay.
It sounds fake.
Like he made up a name?
Yes.
It sounds quite like, possible.
It doesn't sound like a real name.
I mean, obviously, it was an errant prank. There was a misunderstanding. I mean, it would be lovely to go up and just clear
the
whole thing.
Some kind of misunderstanding. Look at this. Is this a misunderstanding to you? His eye is black.
That doesn't look like one, and I, again, apologize. Really appreciate everything that you have helped
us with. I have to tell you, Morgana, I thought we were friends before that.
Well,
I thought we knew each other. I thought we understood each other.
We are friends, and I will tell you that I've not had a very good day, and I honestly, I know you
had a terrible night.
I know you won't believe this, but I don't remember any of that. So that's what I'm trying to figure out.
Do you know why I don't believe that, Morgana?
Why?
Because you had one drink, Morgana.
Yes.
And every night this week you've been in here 10, 15 drinks, staggering home drunk, but one drink and then you attack me?
It is strange, isn't it? Don't you think?
I think it's strange.
And there was a mysterious man named Mysterium here.
I'm sure
this is getting even stranger.
Your shop. Yes. It's, you know, you've been working so hard in your shop. I mean, crazy things happen when people are overworked. I mean, you understand, you run this establishment.
Also,
it's insane during these kinds of holidays.
Has anyone gotten into your stock? Maybe slip some potion or something into any of the drinks?
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
Well, no, maybe that Mysterium did something to your drink, Morgana.
That's what I'm
He's someone we don't know.
No,
and there's lots of people here we don't know. It's Chicken Bear Day.
Yeah, but the name doesn't sound real.
No.
It sounds like
which room was he staying in?
He was staying in the one on the end.
On the end, all right.
The one on the end.
I mean, I would just love to clear this whole thing up. I've known Morgana, and she's just been absolutely lovely, and I would hate to think there'd be any bad blood from that. And from, I mean, obviously, it... You know her. How could it be anything but a misunderstanding?
Thomas, Jack Duke come by.
Well, yeah.
Yeah. And you told him all of this, yeah?
Well, he talked to a lot of the people here.
Yeah, I know he did.
I did try to downplay it because we are friends, but it's hard to downplay it. Just attacking someone out of nowhere.
I understand. I called Jack myself, so I appreciate it and I understand.
You called him?
I told him. I did call him myself because I'm concerned as well.
All right. Well, that sounds more like you. That does.
I mean, mad things happen. You understand that.
Magic is a bit crazy, after all.
Especially around Chicken Bear Day.
Yeah.
Right. Well,
someone could have been pranking Morgana, for all we know.
It could be possible. A few days early.
Early Chicken Bear. What is the world coming to, I tell ya?
During this conversation, I would like to use sense motive to see if I can get a sense that he's on the level here.
Okay.
So I have a +4. So that would give me a 21.
So his motive towards you guys right now is completely honorable.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Azores came through and they asked to see the guy's room and everything. I just showed it to him, showed him up there. It was only a couple of hours ago.
Oh, really?
So I think they're on top of it. I hope you don't get in too much trouble.
Me too, I'm at the goal. Well.
I mean, Chicken Bear Day just gets out of hand sometimes.
It does.
Do you need to go get something from your room?
I do. I need to get several things from my room. You are very sly and observant. We're going upstairs, Tom.
All right. Oh, good job. Sometimes I say things that are weird. guys, I feel like this is a good time to bring BSB Care. An evil wizard in a dark tower looks over you. And, Morgana?
Uh-oh. BSB Care, what did you do?
Oh, no.
Morgana,
what did you do?
Things get fuzzy for you all of a sudden, and Jaina, you're not feeling so good all of a sudden.
Oh, no, seriously? Right now?
Right now.
Oh, no.
Big crowd of people.
This is a real Merlin's Beard moment.
Before we get into this, I do want to say something from last time. I know. I have in the past screwed your spells over on you because I felt like it. For example, Incarcerus, the ropes, she broke them with her strength. The only way that someone can break those ropes with their strength is they have to roll above a 20. A natural 20 won't even do it. It's got, I mean, you know, if they got bonuses, right? It's got to be above a 20. Under that, Incarcerus works, okay?
Okay.
And you cast Stupefy on her, and I had something bump into her. I just didn't want the fight to be over real fast. Stupefy will work for 3 rounds.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'm being fair.
Thank goodness.
People, with your caring, if I'm being fair. Guys, it's too late! Morgana's wolfing out!
Moving to one of the private dining rooms
Morgana,
as quickly as possible.
Who the heck are you about to attack?
Don't follow me!
It's attack time! Do it! Attack them!
Don't follow me!
No, we need to knock you out.
Yes, well,
so you don't attack everyone else.
It's too late. Morgana starts casting.
So how am I choosing who I cast on?
Oh, shit.
Oh, well.
In the process of walking
away.
Who
was the last person you were talking to?
Well, us four and Tom.
All right, do I have enough room to, enough time to at least run into one of the rooms and slam a door?
One, two, three.
All right, I run into this room and I slam the door behind
me. There's people in there having a party.
What? No, there wasn't! You just did that!
I did!
You're the worst person!
You couldn't see because of the walls!
That was the empty room.
Tom is one, two, three, four.
All right, I don't slam the door, obviously, I just get into the room. I'm mostly trying not to be seen turning into a horrible monster.
Hairs coming out of your
face.
Yeah,
that's why I'm diving in around a corner, hopefully, before things happen.
Oh, thank you, Gnome House, for the follow.
Oh, thank you.
Okay. Oh, my.
So you're attacking Tom.
I didn't hear the ding.
Yeah.
So in this instance, I assume I'm using one of my five spells that I normally go for. And am I, I mean, some of them are more dangerous than others.
Yeah, they are.
So I'm trying to figure out, which one do I go for?
Roll a six-sided die.
Of course. I don't know why I asked
Let the dice decide.
Am I at least I able to do it one, where two, some three, no four, one five. Is actually seeing this occur?
Well, that's just Benita and Cantata.
Because that's the bigger thing is
you're
that
you're dressed in such a way that
you're just
like,
trying to cancel all the
you know,
spells.
Like you duck your head and like you probably wear gloves.
That one's not so bad.
Or you're gothy.
So
you can disguise it to a degree, but you don't have time.
Yeah, I'm just trying to get out of the way and not be spotted. So I do live here.
Yeah.
My third spell.
I guess I'm
is
just down the hole.
Finite incantatum, which is just ending.
No, you can't use that one.
So close.
Cheating pants. What's happening?
No. Incarcerous.
Mother. Okay, incarcerous. You're just gonna start casting incarcerous.
All right. So I cast incarcerous on Tom. Incarcerous.
You wrap him up in ropes. Mm-hmm. Guys, this is something special I had planned for you. You're now in combat, so let's roll. This is great. You're not even in combat with me. You're in combat with each other. So roll for initiative.
Woo!
But,
oh, that's good.
You guys figure out your order. But guys, something's gone terribly wrong with Morgana and her bloodlust, because now when her bloodlust is activated, she goes every other person. So, like, you'll roll initiative and you'll get your order, and it will go Morgana, someone else, Morgana, someone else, Morgana, someone else.
Well, all right then.
Six. I still rolled higher than you.
This guy has blue hands.
Eight.
Yeah, he's blue to himself.
Ten.
Use him for Burgermeister.
All right.
Well, just with the last breath I have, all I have is get away!
Okay, yeah.
Oh, and then that.
Okay, we'll do that.
All right, so you cast Incarcerous on Tom. You're now a wolf. Are you in this room?
I'm in the hallway.
You're in the hallway, because there were people having a party in all
the rooms.
I wouldn't
have been able to get into the room, probably.
Okay, fair enough.
It was a bit far.
Evil BSB care. Evil wizard, you.
So evil.
Go.
All right, so I'm going to Incarcerous or try to wrap her up.
Okay.
So she doesn't hurt anybody.
Try it.
All right. Incarcerous. It's an eight.
Is it an eight?
Plus, what do I get? Anything on that. What level is that? Sorry. I should know before I do that.
It's level two.
Braid.
Level
this is
two.
A free spell.
Braid.
Braid, who loves me. As all good people should.
It's a level two spell.
Gave me a reroll. Okay.
No brain, no.
And she gave me the opportunity to surprise two of you with Birdie Bop Beans. This seems like a good time.
Wow.
While everyone's figuring out how not to die.
You figure out how not to die and you two just got beaned.
You're killing our characters, you're making us eat beans.
Oh guys, I've been looking forward to this moment all day.
Right, wait,
okay, I'll wait. Here, you want to see what it is?
That's a flavor that exists.
In front of the camera. I don't know what it is.
Ooh, that looks disgusting. We're good. Whatever okay. it is.
All right. Oh God.
This is weirdly sweet, though.
Did I miss a good one?
I think so. It's actually pretty sweet.
Hey, this is actually pretty good too.
What?
I like it.
It was watermelon.
Wow. How did I miss a watermelon?
Thank you, Teline.
Dang it.
Thank you, Brian.